So interestingly enough, CIR is doing pretty darn good for the month of January. Just looking at the numbers on Friday that you gave to me, CIR is up 8.7% year to date for the number of deals that we've done so far in January, while CREB's numbers are down about 1.5%. So you guys are rocking it. Nice work.
Yeah.
You know, I know this seems hard, but everybody thinks that January, December, January are kind of slower months, but I'm impressed that you guys are just out there hitting the pavement, drumming up business, and working with those new mortgage rules and making sure that those clients who are pre-approved before December 31st, that they're able to get their purchase done on time. So,
yeah. No, it's been busy. You were on call this weekend. How was it?
You know what? It wasn't that busy.
Yeah.
So,
everybody's out doing deals instead of asking questions.
Maybe. Yeah. Or we're just training our realtors so well that they don't have a lot of questions.
There you go. That's a good thing.
Yeah.
I think the price of oil is definitely helping. We're seeing some stabilization over top of that $60 mark. We're currently sitting at $66.20, which is phenomenal. It doesn't seem all that long ago we were talking about $40.
Yeah, we'd be happy with $40. Yeah.
So this is doing really good, as well as our Canadian dollar's up a little bit as well. So I'm doing quite well there.
Right. Yeah. Number of listings, Metro Calgary. We are up a bit at 4,800 or so listings. So that was up a bit from last week at 4,654. And Red Deer, you're only up by about 13 listings and 540 as compared to 527 last week.
That's good that it's going up, because I'm eager to see more listing inventory coming on. I was actually chatting with some of our existing tenants, and now they're looking to buy a place.
Oh.
And there just isn't a lot of options out there for them. Good options. So
yeah, I was going to say, there seems like there's listings, but not a lot of great product.
Yeah. So, which we see this time of year regularly, so it'll be nice to see the listing inventory bump up. I know we're down. Last year, we carried about 2,000 listings through the majority of the year, and we're around 1,400 right now. So it'll be nice to see that bump back.
So that's a good indicator for all of our realtors to get out there and talk to their clients and start prepping them. I know everybody thinks that they want to list in the spring, but if there isn't a lot of great product on the market now, that it might be the perfect time to get your really good product listed.
Yeah, and speaking of those tenants, we are going to be listing that property. We've got a little condo, and it is the perfect time because there isn't a lot of supply. So,
great.
The absorption rates, that's been dropping, which is also a good sign, about 5.6 months inventory. So a buyer's market still, but it is coming down, which will expect to see that trend to continue coming into spring as the markets pick up. Single family homes are just over 4 months, and the condo market is still at 8.6 months, but it's coming down as well. And I'm still hopeful for the condo market based on November and December. November being the rental vacancy rate dropping for the first time in 3 years, which if the vacancy rate in the rentals drops, that's going to push people into the buyer's market. The first time buyer's market in 2017 wasn't fantastic, where the bulk of the sales was in that 550 to 1.1 million as far as increasing. So that's good signs. And then also the sales in December for condos was up just over 16%, and listings was only up about 8%. So sales were
just keep all these numbers in your head like that, hey?
Yeah. Well, only the interesting ones, because the condo market hasn't had good news in three or 4 years. So
here's a question. Do you think that the condo market will feel a bit of pressure in terms of sales because the buyers will have less buying power with the new mortgage rules?
I don't think the condo market will be affected as much, because it's over the changes of the mortgage rules was over 20%. Down payments. So your first time buyers aren't typically going to be putting that down. So I'm anticipating the first time market to see a pickup where we didn't see that last year.
Yeah.
And then that will also push up the people moving up the property ladder. So I'm anticipating a good 2018.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah. Surrounding areas, months of inventory. Okotoks also improving. 6 months inventory. Cochrane slowed down a little bit, just about coming up on 11 months inventory. Sundry stayed even. Red Deer's down a little bit, improving. Airdrie's up just over 7 months inventory. Strathmore hovering around that 12-month inventory. Chestermere is around seven. So I noticed that, and this is fantastic, but there's more and more agents that are sharing these slides, which is excellent because education is key to anything. Mm-hmm. And there's a saying, I can't remember where I originally heard it, but the fastest way to not progressing forward is overwhelm and not understanding how something works. So when you're sharing these things, it's really important to tell people why we're looking at the absorption rates and what does it mean? Because, I mean, outside of the industry, what does an absorption rate mean?
Yeah. I have to say, before I got into real estate, what's a buyer's market? What's a balanced market? What's a seller's market? So it's our job as realtors to educate our clients.
Right.
And if you can figure out a way to say it in the way that your client responds the best, remember that. Remember that you have to communicate the way that your client will hear you. So just... Yeah.
My favorite way to explain it is how long the market can sustain itself without any new inventory coming on. So if we have 10 listings and 5 sales, that's 2 months inventory. And then 0 to 2 months, seller's market 2 to 4, balanced market 4 to 6. Now this does vary a little bit in markets. That's inside of the Calgary market. But it's important to educate your clients as to why we pay attention to those numbers.
Yeah. So, and the benchmark price for Calgary is at $433,200 for the past week.